नमस्कार फ्रेंड्स, एज डिस्कस्ड ड्यूरिंग माय प्रीवियस वीडियो, इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑल कंटेंट्स वन बाय वन रिगार्डिंग प्रपोज शेड्यूल एम. बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दिस वीडियो आई रिक्वेस्ट ऑल ऑफ यू टू विजिट अर्लियर वीडियो ऑन द सेम टॉपिक सो दैट यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड the content of proposed schedule M versus the content of current schedule M. उस वीडियो में मैंने क्लियरली बताया है कि क्या क्या कंटेंट चेंज हुआ है, तो समझने में आसानी होगी. इस वीडियो में हम लोग क्या देखने वाले हैं कि प्रपोज शेड्यूल एम में जो भी कंटेंट आया हुआ है उसको थोड़ा इलैबोरेट करने वाले हैं. तो अंडरस्टैंडिंग के लिए आपको प्रीवियस वीडियो देखना बहुत जरूरी है, आपको प्रीवियस वीडियो को देखना चाहिए. हमने प्रीवियस वीडियो में ये डिस्कस किया था कि बैकग्राउंड क्या था, कहां से आया वीडियो. उसमें जैसे कि प्रीवियस करंट शेड्यूल एम जो है उसमें हमारे दो पार्ट ही थे, अभी नए में 13 पार्ट आए हुए हैं. तो ये सारी चीजें मैंने स्टेप बाय स्टेप उसमें डिस्कस की हुई है, तो प्लीज विजिट दैट वीडियो बिफोर व्यूइंग दिस वीडियो, राइट. सो दिस इज द रिक्वेस्ट. लेट अस बिगिन विद करंट वीडियो, प्रपोज शेड्यूल एम. इन प्रपोज शेड्यूल एम the first content is pharmaceutical quality system. What is the expectation of proposed schedule M regarding the pharmaceutical quality system? This is new addition as compared to the current schedule M. In this proposed schedule M, it is expected that manufacturer must assume the responsibility of quality and do not place patient at risk due to inadequate quality or safety or efficacy or three of them. So this is clearly defined that it is manufacturer's responsibility. Similarly, clear cut instructions given about the responsibility of higher management. Now higher management cannot say I am not responsible, and at the same time all technical persons involved in the manufacturing of the product are equally responsible for the quality, safety and efficacy of the product. So this proposed schedule M clearly defines that senior management has an ultimate responsibility to implement the pharmaceutical quality system throughout the company. Here one more expectation is that you should focus on the GMP requirement, good manufacturing practices requirement. Similarly, you have to focus on the quality risk management, right? And one more thing is mentioned about the you have to conduct the periodic management review meeting. Periodic MRMs shall be conducted by the management. In this MRM, you have to discuss all the QMS related issues, GMP related issues, product quality related issues, and that expectation was there in the previous current schedule M also. Apart from this, one more expectation is that manufacturer must establish a document called a quality manual or similar kind of document. In the quality manual, we all know we have to discuss about the all the precautions we are going to take for the maintaining the quality of our product. One more important area discussed in the proposed schedule M is that product and process knowledge is managed throughout the life cycle of the product, throughout the life cycle stages. That means right from the product development to the dispatch to the marketing, you have to give the knowledge to all persons involved in this all activities. For example, development guys must know about the process develop and the product. Similarly, manufacturer, the persons involved in the testing, the persons involved in the marketing also should have the sufficient knowledge of the product and process as per requirement. This is the requirement of proposed schedule M. And procedure for the self-inspection or quality audit should be established. This is clearly a requirement of the proposed schedule M. Apart from this, regarding the vendor qualification, also proposed schedule M speaks that is material shall be procured only from the approved vendors. That means you have to have the procedure for vendor qualification. Product release should be in line with the conditions of the license and in line with the applicable all regulations. That means you cannot say that I am complying with the schedule M so that I cannot comply with the other regulatory requirements. You have to comply with conditions of license as well as other applicable regulations. You have to maintain the consistency in the product quality. This is the requirement. And continual improvement is the key. Initially, who know about the ISO requirements, they must be aware of improvement in the quality, but now it is a GMP requirement. All deviations, defects, non-compliances shall be detected, investigated and recorded. This is also a requirement which defined under the pharmaceutical quality system. And whenever you come across any failure, you have to take the CAPA. One more specific requirement is that you have to implement the CAPA as well as you have to monitor the CAPA. That is, you have to monitor the corrective actions and preventive actions. These requirements are covered under the pharmaceutical quality system. Another most important area discussed in the Schedule M, that is introduced in the proposed Schedule M, is quality risk management. QRM, till today we are also following the quality risk management, but based on the ICS guideline. Here also expectation remains similar, but it is now a mandatory requirement. It is written in the Schedule M, proposed Schedule M. So we have to comply with the requirements of the Schedule M. And the content is same, that you have to assess the risk, you have to take the measures to control or mitigate the risk, you have to communicate the risk to the respective stakeholders, and you have to review the risk associated with the product manufacturing, product testing. Here they have given a freedom that you can implement quality risk management proactively as well as retrospectively. Before starting the activity, you go for the risk assessment, find out the risk associated, take the appropriate actions, mitigate the risk, and then start your activity. Or if you have started the activity, then also you can assess the risk associated with the product manufacturing. That requirement is there and that freedom is also there. Ultimate goal is the safety of the patient or protection of the patient. Under the quality risk management, the product quality review or annual product quality review, we are aware that APQR or PQR we are conducting, that was there in the previous Schedule M also, but now this covered under the quality risk management of the proposed Schedule M. Here the requirements are same. For example, at least annually you have to do the quality risk management or product quality risk management, right? And what things has to be covered, at least you have to cover the starting material source, starting material release status, supply chain traceability of the active substances, critical in process controls, review of critical in process controls, finished product result, review of all failed batches of the all product you manufactured. You have to run the APQR, you have to follow the APQR for all product manufactured at site. In case you are not manufactured a product for 1 year and that product is manufactured for previous year, then also you have to go for the product quality review document. You have to establish that document. In this quality review document or product quality review document, you have to consider the dosage variations. You have to consider the technical agreements. You have to review the quality trends related to returns, recall, complaints, deviations associated, change controls associated with that, and related CAPA and its investigation records. That has to be covered under the PQR or APQR. One more thing is that definition for GMP has been introduced in the Schedule M. It was there in the WHO guideline, it was there in the other guidelines, but in Schedule M it was not there. But in proposed Schedule M, definition of good manufacturing practice, GMP, is introduced. What is that definition? That definition is, GMP is that part of quality management which ensures that products are consistently produced and controlled according to the quality standards appropriate to their intended use as required by licensee. And aim of GMP is consistency in the process, consistency in the quality of the product, managing and minimizing the risk associated with the manufacturing process, risk associated with the testing process, and risk associated with the quality of the product. Good manufacturing practice continues. All manufacturing processes are, as per good manufacturing practices, it is expected that all manufacturing processes are clearly defined and reviewed for associated risk. All manufacturing processes are capable of consistently manufacturing pharmaceutical products of desired quality or required quality. You have to perform the qualification and validation as per requirement. Under the qualification and validation head, we will discuss in detail about the what are the qualification requirements, what are the validation requirements as per Schedule M, proposed Schedule M. Instructions and procedures are written in clear and unambiguous language and correctly followed. That is the requirement as per GMP. Records should be complete, traceable, comprehensive, and accessible. That means you have to follow good manufacturing practice. You have to follow the expectation or principles of data integrity. So DI as well as GDP you have to follow. Recall procedures, market complaint, CAPA procedures are available and followed. Ultimate aim of GMP is risk mitigation or risk control. Next topic is sanitization and hygiene. In existing Schedule M, sanitization and hygiene mainly covers for workers and manufacturing premises. But in proposed Schedule M, scope of sanitization and hygiene covers personal, premises, equipment, production material, material or product used for the cleaning also. That means cleaning agents also comes into the scope of the good manufacturing practice. Cleaning aids like PPE or brooms, that is also comes under the scope of the GMP as per proposed Schedule M. Apparatus, product cleaning, disinfectants, anything which comes into the contact of the product now considered under the Schedule M requirement for sanitization and hygiene. Next topic is qualification and validation. As discussed earlier, qualification and under qualification and validation, existing Schedule M does not speak anything about the qualification. It speaks about the validation, and that too validation is limited to the manufacturing process, testing and cleaning process as per Schedule M. Although we follow other guidelines and we do qualification validation for the equipment utilities, but it was not mentioned in the current Schedule M. But in proposed Schedule M is more specific about the qualification and validation requirements. As per the proposed Schedule M, you have to establish and provide documentary evidence that the premises, supporting utilities, equipment and processes have been qualified in line with the GMP requirements. That means you have to follow the validation and qualification as per requirement of the industry or as per the GMP requirements. As discussed, in proposed Schedule M, validation scope also increased. In addition to manufacturing process, testing and cleaning, validation requirement for the premises, utility and equipment is added in proposed Schedule M. Qualification requirement was not there in the current Schedule M, but in proposed Schedule M, this requirement is clearly mentioned that for the utility, premises, equipment and processes, you have to qualify those equipment, process, utilities for the DQ, IQ, OQ, PQ, and also you have to define the requirement for revalidation or requalification criteria. You have to define requalification, revalidation period also you have to define as per proposed Schedule M. Next topic is compliance and adverse reaction. एज पर एग्जिस्टिंग शेड्यूलियम और एज पर करंट शेड्यूलियम सीरियस एडवर्स रिएक्शन शैल बी इन्फॉर्म टू द लाइसेंसिंग अथॉरिटी. दैट वॉज द ओनली रिक्वायरमेंट दैट इन केस ऑफ सीरियस एडवर्स रिएक्शन यू हैव टू इंटीमेट टू द लाइसेंसिंग अथॉरिटी. बट एज पर प्रपोज शेड्यूलियम अपार्ट फ्रॉम द सीरियस एडवर्स रिएक्शन यू हैव टू कीप इन्फॉर्म लाइसेंसिंग अथॉरिटी अबाउट द एनी रिकॉल और सप्लाई रिस्ट्रिक्शन ड्यू टू एनी नॉन कंप्लायंस यू हैव टू इंटीमेट टू द लाइसेंसिंग अथॉरिटी. इन एडिशन टू दैट यू हैव टू एस्टैब्लिश फार्माको विजिलेंस सिस्टम दैट शुड बी इन प्लेस. दैट इज द रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ प्रपोज शेड्यूल एम. नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज प्रोडक्शन अंडर लोन लाइसेंस कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एनालिसिस और कॉन्ट्रैक्ट मैन्युफैक्चरिंग अदर कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एक्टिविटीज. This is one of the major addition to proposed Schedule M. As per this addition, requirement is that if you wish to manufacture a product on the contract basis, you wish to test the product, that means contract manufacturing, contract testing or any other contract activity, you have to comply with this requirement. What is the requirement? Requirement is that there should be a technical agreement between the contract acceptor and contract giver. What is the minimum content of that technical agreement or quality agreement? Responsibility should be clearly defined. About what? About who is responsible for batch release, who is responsible for complaint handling, who investigate the complaints, who investigate OS, who investigate deviations, who log deviations. That all requirements should be discussed in the contract agreement, that is technical agreement or quality agreement. Even there should be a document which provide the evidence about the technology transfer, and that document also provide the evidence that contract manufacturer as well as contract acceptor both are on the same page with respect to the knowledge about the manufacturing, testing, distribution of the product to be manufactured and all risk associated with the manufacturing, testing and distribution of the product. That is the requirement and this is the major addition to proposed Schedule M. Thank you for watching this video. Before closing this video, I have one announcement that we have discussed only 7 areas of proposed Schedule M. Other areas are still pending. So watch my next video also. And please like, share, subscribe my channel. And don't forget to hit the bell icon to get the notification for all upcoming videos. Thank you.